especially when you have a bunch of young guys who've never been to Syracuse before. You know, you try to obviously show them visuals, show them past teams on what they did on the court. But just, you know, we showed them pictures just of the dome. And, it is a lot more than they're accustomed to. But, it's an adjustment. You know, you can't really simulate, obviously, and until you hear and you're experiencing it. But our guys are excited, and just got to go out there and continue to play and do the things we worked on in preparation for the game. But just enjoy it.
Corey, you can feel it in the city. You can feel it in the building. We've got a crowd of over 30,000, the largest in college basketball this year. There's a real buzz in the dome tonight.
And Duke wearing their Brotherhood uniforms for this game. Only the second time they've worn them this season, and maybe the last time they'll wear them this season.
Big-time affair in the ACC. And off we go from the Carrier Dome. The Blue Devils control the opening tap.
Game for the first time, Alex O'Connell beating the post for the dunk by DeLaurier.
Here we go.
Off the inbound, carry to stuff it home. Thought about firing instead to the right and Moore. He will fire and hit a three.
Wendell Moore drains a big time shot to bring the Blue Devils back to within two.
Inside, spun out of it, pulled up and tied the game. To Sidibe, blocked by White. And now here's Moore headed the other way. Four on two, bounce pass to DeLaurier, catches and lays it in.
This is what good teams do. They take the crowd out of it and just stem the tide, stay in it, and that's what the Blue Devils have done.
A strong finish to the first half by the Blue Devils.
And Cooper Stanley as Terry dumps it down inside. And now we get a whistle. I think he just got teed up. And Carey comes up with the basketball, flings it ahead for Stanley. What a catch. Put it off the window. Oh, my goodness. Give him two. The rebound, White tapped it outside for O'Connell. He'll reload and hit.
Alex O'Connell loves shooting in this building, and he just put the Blue Devils up by 12.
The carry spins up on three defenders, put it off the window. Count it! And a chance for three. Steps to the right, jacks the three. Short, Stanley there to flush it home. Duke in transition with Stanley. Chase from behind, goes with the right hand! Give it to him! And a chance for three. And for Duke, an 18th win. Their eighth in the ACC as they come to the Carrier Dome and beat the Orange 97-88.
Hey Duke, we back. I got my boy AO here. Got my boy Wendell here. We got Vern here. We just got the dub in Syracuse. And we got Sav here. Hey, my boy Sav got verified. Everybody go follow on Instagram. We're going to put it right here. Boom, right here. But anyway, get back to you. I'm going to start with AO first.
Okay.
AO, you had 11 points off the bench. You brought a lot of energy. It feels like, anytime you play Syracuse, you really cut them up. Talk to me about that.
To just come here with confidence, knowing that zone is going to have open gaps and just, being ready to attack it and get my teammates open shots.
Yeah, I mean, it seemed like during walkthrough, during practice, you're really energized. Did you bring that energy?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I got a little bit of a reputation in this gym, so I had to live up to it again, talking a little bit of smack, what I'm saying?
We love that. I'm going to go to Wendell first. Wendell. Wendell came in, brought some big buckets, hit some clutch free throws, and also, really got it going because, he's been gone for so long. So, Wendell, talk to me about coming into this game.
Man, I'm just glad to be back, man. I'm going to keep it quick. I ain't really got much to say. Glad to be back with the boys and got an eighth win in the ACC.
Yes, sir. Great vibes.
All right.
To the man now.
26 points, 17 rebounds, an alley-oop slam assisted by me, and a technical. So, talk to me, man. The people say the zone was going to throw you off, but clearly you weren't thrown off. So talk to me about, your mindset coming into the game.
Just to stay aggressive, really, and just find the openings on the baseline, really, and just just being strong with the ball. That was one of the emphasis coming in the game, so just being strong with it for us.
It's a great win, and we got number 8. We did it for a lot of people, and you know, shout out Coach Sire, man. Prayers up. Shout out Bull City. You know, RIP Kobe and GG. You know, we signing out.
We'll see you Tuesday.
All right, dude. It's the intro of the music video right here.
What's up, Duke fans? It's Nolan Smith here.
Nolan Smith with a slam!
And today, we're going to give you a behind-the-scenes look on how we came up with our new uniforms this year. 5 of our 6 uniforms have been revealed, and I know you guys are loving them. So, we're going to give you an inside scoop of the behind-the-scenes.
We just got a big surprise here, these new jerseys.
The masterminds, the designs, a little bit of everything on how we came up with the new uniforms. So this year you've seen our classic Duke uniforms, white, blue, and black. And Nike really did a great job showing exactly what our vision was, which was throwback, iconic look. That's what we were really going for when we sat down and started looking at the old school uniforms that you've seen, thinking back to the 90s, 80s, the 2000s, 2010s. 2015, and it all came together. They're iconic. They're Duke basketball, and one thing that they put on every single one is the brotherhood down at the bottom of the jersey. So you have the white there, the blue, the clean blue look, the waistband. The waistband really came together with just a strong statement of the waistband. The waistband is important part of the jersey, I'd like to say. When you tuck your uniform in and you see that Duke logo popping, that's what it's all about. The side, old school, stripe going down the side. I mean, that's Jay Williams, Christian Laettner, old school Duke style. Here it is on the black uniform. Looks good, looks clean. So we were very excited when we saw these coming in. The two uniforms that we were most excited about were the Coach K uniform and the Brotherhood uniform, in which you've all seen them. They looked great on court. Our players loved them. And they took a lot of time. So first I want to talk about the Coach K uniform and what went into designing this uniform. When you think about Duke basketball, you think about Coach K and you think about the Brotherhood. And that's what we thought about when we sat down. We were like, we need to come up with a special jersey. And the two jerseys came out perfect. We started Googling and we looked up West Point. And first thing that popped up West Point was a Coach K picture and a number 12 jersey. And we were like, all right, it was gray. So that's how we came up with the color, gray. So let's go with gray. So what colors can we put in this uniform? Gold and blue, gold. Gold is also a part of West Point, but then we thought, okay, gold also has to do with his USA basketball background, and we put the gold in for his gold medals, and that's really gonna make the jersey pop, as which y'all have seen. And a couple features on these jerseys, and on the inside, you have duty, honor, and country. Anybody knows that's, you know what that means, duty, honor, and country. And when Coach saw that, Coach was very excited to see that on the bottom of the jersey. So when our players wore these uniforms, they knew what they were playing for. On all 5 of our uniforms, there's a couple things we wanted to keep consistent, and that was the waistband. As you can see right here on the Coach K uniform, the waistband, we kept it nice and thick and kept it strong. And we wanted that to always be the focal point of each uniform. And another focal point being the side of the uniforms with the color and the lines going down the side, you know, reaching the bottom point of the jersey. Then lastly, probably the biggest jersey, probably made the biggest splash in all of your minds. I'm sure everyone was excited when they saw these, but the Brotherhood jersey. And we think of Duke basketball, you think about the Brotherhood. We kept the Duke basketball logo on the side, which was clean. You have the Brotherhood logo on the waistband. We kept the waistband the same thickness, and it popped with the Brotherhood logo. And now let's get to the color. The color of this uniform was navy. And we came up with navy. We thought back to just Duke University, the school. And we have Letterman jackets that every single athlete gets here, and the color is navy. So it's a color that's not foreign. We didn't make it up. Navy is a university color. And this logo, when Dave and I Googled Duke University, this logo comes up. And Dave said, this is the logo for this uniform. So that's how we came up with this logo to put on the front. It's just iconic. You know, our university is a historically amazing university with great history, rich tradition. And for the Brotherhood jersey really just came together nicely with all of the designs that we wanted to make sure we kept in them and kept consistent throughout our jerseys. And that brought us to this uniform right here, the Brotherhood jersey. So it was a very exciting process. I'm very happy and honored to be a part of it, working with Dave Bradley. It was a great year for just to see these on court and to finally reveal them to our team. The excitement for those guys to put them on, to wear the Brotherhood jersey, to wear the Coach K jersey. It was just a big year, you know. And now you look good, you play good. We have to continue to do that this year. And, you know, thank y'all for checking out our new uniforms.
Halfway home in league play, and the Blue Devils are right in the thick of the ACC race. Of course, now the ACC slate is 20 games deep, and 10 games in at 8-2, Duke still has quite a bit of basketball left. Yet another reason to lock in. It's back to work for Duke in Chestnut Hill.
Emil Jefferson, Nick Pags, Jason Tatum. We got Deuce here supporting the Brotherhood. Go Duke!
Number 7 Duke takes the floor against the Eagles of Boston College. Deflected on the way out on the pass. The theft for Jack White.
Now White.
2-on-1. Give it to Stanley!
Yes, it's Stanley!
Give him the tomahawk! And the lead is down to 3.
Look, Boston College fans got up off their feet for that one. Holy smokes!
It was not an offensive thing of beauty in the first half. Duke had his worst offensive half of the season, if they're still down by only 3.
Ball up for Mitchell, blocked by Moore, and Jones out of there with it. Into the post, trying to beat Carey, deflected by Boston College, but the big fella got it back and rocked the rim.
Trey Jones softly rolls one in.
That's tough. That's going to be hard to defend.
Go line for Stanley at the top of the key, a crossover into the paint, put it up and in! And a chance for 3. What a strong finish with the right hand. Looking to drive. In on Moore, cut off, picked up his dribble, fed it to the left, stolen by Delorier. Jones, the outlet pass, has it, goes in alone and lays it in. And Duke is back in front.
Joey Baker into the game. He draws the foul, and he's not going to get a three-pointer, but a chance at a three-point play.
Baker looking to drive. Spun on Mitchell, picked up his dribble, fed Jones on the baseline, scooped it to Delorier. Hesitates, goes up and lays it in off the right side. Moore in front of the bench. Cross-court feed for Baker. A nice catch. Can't shoot, though. Put it on the deck. All the way in. Off the window. Give it to him! Do it the old-fashioned way. A chance for 3.
How about the lift that Joey Baker has given to?
Jones, a jab step, looking to drive. Fed Baker on the left. 3 ball up. And in! The first of the night comes from the sophomore.
And the streak goes to 1,081 in consecutive games with a 3. And Carey has it. Carey has 15. He's so strong.
5:34 to go. To the left, it's Jones. He has a driving lane, thought better of it. 20-footer, up and in. And with that, Jim Christian wants a timeout.
This extended pressure for Duke has been good. Forced some turnovers, but also just kind of controls the offensive attack. Duke came out, went zone, probably to protect Vernon Carey.
And now deflected and stolen by Jones.
Moore in on Thornton, put it up and in off the window.
Pressure in the full court. Blue Devils take a turnover and turn it into a fast break. They're up by five.
Jones gonna drive and lay it in off the left side.
Trey Jones now with 16.
You gotta think Duke has confidence with a guy like Trey Jones on the floor, though. He's just got great poise. Knows how to finish a game.
Gobar driving, got inside, fed Moore on the left, nearly lost it, flung it back out to midcourt to Jones. Jones driving inside, floats up, no, DeLorean there to tap it in!
Yes, sir!
And Duke was challenged. Boston College fought hard, but just not quite enough in terms of offensive firepower to pull off the upset, and the Blue Devils will head into a game at North Carolina, having won a couple on the road against Syracuse and now Boston College. Fewest points Duke has scored this season, but they get the 63-55 win.
It wasn't easy, but Duke got it done on the road. In their 40th year, head coach has ACC win number 500. Remarkable for Mike Krzyzewski. Yet another record and yet another milestone, and the Blue Devils win on the road tonight, 63-55.